So hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we'll be doing oxidation and reduction experiments. So remember to like, share, and comment, and subscribe, and hit that post notification bell.
All right. So for the first two experiments, we are going to add. So we have two solutions. Of one is copper sulfate, and the next one is zinc sulfate. All right. So we are going to add zinc metal to the copper sulfate and copper metal to the zinc sulfate. Right? So if a redox reaction takes place, we are going to see some visible change. Most instance, it will be a color change, right? So I'm going to add zinc metal, so copper sulfate, and I'm going to add the zinc metals to it. So you can notice, if you see anything occurring with the zinc, so if you notice the zinc, it's not completely gray anymore, right? So this is the zinc metal, right? But if you look, as you can see, it is changing color. Alright?
Yes, sir.
Alright, so continuing, if you look now. Alright? You can see that the appearance of the zinc is changing. Alright? So remember, this was the appearance of the zinc metal, right? This is it now. And also, we should take a note of the color of the copper sulfate. Right? We should take a note of the color of the copper sulfate. Right? So you can compare them. Alright, I will come back to this reaction in a few minutes. So this one now is the solution of zinc sulfate. Okay, so now I have the zinc sulfate solution, which is colorless, and I'm going to add some copper turnings. So it's copper metal, alright. I'm going to add some to the zinc sulfate. Right, and we will come back to it in a few minutes and see if anything changes. All right, so at the moment, as you can see, the copper, we don't see any visible reaction occurring. So with the redox reactions, we want to see visible reactions taking place. With the zinc, we clearly notice that the appearance of the zinc metal, it is changing, right? And the color of the copper sulfate solution is clearly not as bright as it was, all right? So I can add some more zinc to it so that the reaction can go on a little quicker. So we are going to look at two other redox reactions now. Alright, so continuing, we are going to do three reactions with potassium dichromate. So potassium dichromate, as you can see, it is an orange solution, right? So the first reaction, I am going to react it with hydrogen peroxide. So it's potassium dichromate with hydrogen peroxide. The reason you see the orange color, the chromium is in the plus 6 oxidation state. It is an oxidizing agent, so it should be reduced. And in most of these reactions, the chromium is reduced from the plus 6 oxidation state to the plus 3 oxidation state. And it will, in that case, it will have a color, a green color. So we are going to see if we can get a green color. So to speed up the reaction, I'm going to add a small amount of sulfuric acid to the potassium dichromate. Alright, so this is acidified potassium dichromate. Now I'm going to add the hydrogen peroxide. So at first it is an intense blue color, blue at first. Alright, and now you can see the green color. So the potassium dichromate, it was reduced from the plus 6 oxidation state into the plus 3 oxidation state. Alright, so you can see the green color. Again, potassium dichromate, it is orange. When you react it with hydrogen peroxide, the color changes to green. The reason for that, the dichromate, the chromate ion in this one, chromium, it is plus 6, so it is orange. Here it is plus 3, it is green. So chromium is a transition metals. So when they change state, they have more than one oxidation state. When they change state, they will have a different color. So it is green because it has changed its oxidation state. Alright, so in the reaction of hydrogen peroxide with acidified potassium dichromate, it changes from orange to green. Without the sulfuric acid, this reaction wouldn't have occurred this quickly. So we add the sulfuric acid to speed up the process. Alright, that means that if potassium dichromate was reduced, it is the oxidizing agent, right? Because remember, oxidizing agents are always reduced. That means the hydrogen peroxide was oxidized. Good. So the next reaction, again with potassium dichromate. This time we are going to react it with ethanol, right? So dichromate, if you do organic chemistry, you will know that alcohols can be oxidized by potassium dichromate to give a carboxylic acid. And if you do it at the advanced level, you will know that primary alcohol gives carboxylic acid and secondary alcohol would give a ketone. But regardless, the alcohol will be oxidized unless it's a tertiary one. Alright, so it's now acidified potassium dichromate because I added a small amount of sulfuric acid. So this time now let's add the ethanol and see if we get the color change again. So it's orange. Let's add some more. Think you can see it changing? Definitely, look at the top, you can see the green color forming, right? It's in a test tube, so I can shake it up, but you can see at the top that it is green now. So the addition of the alcohol change it from orange to green. Eventually all of it will change, right? But you can see that some of it changed from orange to green. So again, that means the dichromate, the chromium ion in the plus 6 oxidation state, it is again reduced to the plus 3, right? Which means that the alcohol is oxidized to the carboxylic acid, right? So again, this is a redox reaction. Once you get a visible change, you know that a reaction is occurring. All right, so this was it before. All right, you can compare the colors. All right, so that's with the dichromate and alcohol. The final one. All right, so for the next reaction with potassium dichromate, we are going to use ferrous ammonium sulfate, right? So we have it here, and we have the potassium dichromate. Again, I'm going to add a small amount of the acid, right? And let's see what happens. So you can see again, we get a green color. So the acid speed up the reaction. So I added some more acid a while ago, right? So again, this is the dichromate. This is it now, changing from orange to green, right? So you can see in the three reactions, the potassium dichromate is changing from orange to green. In this one, chromium is what is causing the color change. It is decreasing from plus 6 to plus 3. Alright, so that's it for the reactions with potassium dichromate. We are going to do the same reactions again, but this time we are going to use potassium permanganate. Alright, and that is a purple solution. Okay, so for the first one now, we are going to react the potassium permanganate, so purple solution, right, with alcohol again. So as usual, I'm going to add a small amount of sulfuric acid, right, and then I'm going to add the alcohol. So potassium permanganate, when it is acting as the oxidizing agent, it can have a brown appearance. It can go to colorless as well, or pink, but in this instance we are looking for it to go to colorless. Going to add some more acid. As you can see, it has the brown appearance. So I'm going to continue adding alcohol. And now you can see, right, it is changing color, right? So as you can see, it changed from purple to colorless. So it was brown initially, but it became colorless, right? So potassium permanganate here, it's an oxidizing agent. The reason why you see it change from purple to colorless, when it's purple, it's in the plus 7 oxidation state. So just like chromium, the Mn, which is manganese, it has more than one oxidation state. So in the permanganate ion, MnO4 minus, it is in the plus 7 oxidation state. So it is purple. But when it gets colorless, it is in the plus 2 oxidation state. Alright, so manganese here now is in the plus 2 oxidation state. So it can go plus 7, plus 4, plus 2. Alright? Alright, so for the second reaction, we are going to use again hydrogen peroxide with potassium permanganate. So acidify it. Alright. And then I'm going to add the hydrogen peroxide. Alright. As you can see, it was brown initially and then colorless. The gas being given off here is oxygen, right? So again, it changed from purple to colorless. But the hydrogen peroxide, it is broken down and it will release oxygen gas. To prove that it's oxygen gas, I'm going to use a wooden splint, right? I'm going to light it and then out the flame, right? When I place it in the test tube, if it relights, it's oxygen gas that is present. So to do that, I have to do the reaction again. All right. So let's go again. So first, alright. Alright, so here I have my lighted splint. Alright, quickly I'm going to add this. As you can see, it relighted because of the oxygen gas. Alright, let's do it again if I want. Alright. There you have it. Alright. So as long as oxygen gas is there, it relights, right? So yes, so again it changed from purple to colorless as well, right? So that's two. We did it with alcohol, we did it with with peroxide, and the final one again is with iron sulfate. For the final one with potassium permanganate, it's with the ferrous sulfate, ferrous ammonium sulfate. Alright. So I'm going to acidify it as usual. Then I add the ferrous ammonium sulfate. Let me add a little more acid. There we have it changing. All right. So we can see it being decolorized. that some more. All right, so if I added more, all right, hold on. So let me pour out some, all right, and then add more. See if it changes. All right, so it stops here. It's not going to colorless. All right, so it stops here. Alright, so I paused the video and did it again. Alright, I got this appearance. But if you know this one, alright, so I can show it again. Let me get the next test tube. Alright, so here we go again. But unlike with the alcohol from carboxylic acid, which is colorless, right? The hydrogen peroxide broken into water and oxygen, but the in this one with the iron sulfate, the iron is not forming up. The iron Fe2+ is being oxidized to Fe3+. Right, so the Fe2+ is going to be oxidized to Fe3+. So when we do it, it will not go completely colorless, because Fe3+ is a colored compound. So whereas with the hydrogen peroxide, the Mn2+ of the permanganate, which is colorless, the peroxide is being broken down into water and oxygen, which is colorless. In the case of the ethanol, as I said, the carboxylic acid formed would be colorless. So the entire reaction is colorless. But in this, the Fe2+, right, is being oxidized to Fe3+, which is not a colorless compound. So it will have a color, right? So it won't go colorless. All right. So we did three reactions with potassium, dichromate, and they all changed to green, right? Let me do back the one with the hydrogen peroxide. That one did not go completely green. Let me do it again and see if we can get it there. So we get the intense blue color, as you can see. All right, let me add some more. All right, let's wait a little. But it's changing to green. All right, so we get a nice green color. So it's orange to green. So the other two, where was it? So these are the three reactions in which the dichromate acted as the oxidizing agent. All right, these are the three of them. And for the potassium permanganate, two were colorless, but the one that contained the Fe2+, this is it. Alright. So these are the three reactions. Hydrogen peroxide, alcohol, and the iron sulfate. An update. This is the reaction now with the zinc and copper sulfate. So remember, this is the color of copper sulfate, right? when I added zinc metal to it, this is the color. So the color of the copper sulfate has faded. The reason for that, when you add copper metal, so the reason why this is now colorless, when you add zinc metal to copper sulfate, the zinc metal is above copper in the reactivity series, right? So as a result, zinc will displace copper. So what you know of is zinc sulfate, which is a colorless solution. So the copper ions, which is the reason why copper sulfate is blue, is no longer present because it has been displaced by zinc ions. So what you know of is zinc sulfate and copper atoms. So you start out with zinc metal and copper sulfate, but at the moment what you have is copper metals and zinc sulfate. Again, if you forgot how zinc metal looks, it's the gray color, right? This was the zinc. That's not it now, right? This is copper sulfate. As you can see, it changed from blue to colorless. So that was a redox reaction. On the other hand, when we placed the copper metal in zinc sulfate, nothing happened. And if you have done oxidation and reduction, you should know that copper is below zinc, so it cannot displace zinc from zinc sulfate. So no reaction occurred as a result. Zinc is above copper, it displaces copper from copper sulfate. Copper is below zinc, so it cannot displace zinc. So this one is not a redox reaction because copper cannot displace zinc from zinc sulfate. But zinc metal can displace copper from copper sulfate. Visible reaction took place, redox reaction. No visible reaction took place, not a redox reaction. And I think we've done all of the redox reactions that I've planned. There's one more. Now, as we know, when metals react with acid, it forms salt and hydrogen gas. But that is actually a redox reaction. It's a displacement one. So the metal will displace hydrogen from the acid. So if we use magnesium, magnesium is above hydrogen, it will displace the hydrogen, right? If we use zinc, the same thing. Zinc will displace the hydrogen from the acid. So the acid and metal reaction is also a single displacement. So the metal displaces the hydrogen, right? So we can confirm that hydrogen gas is present by placing a lighted splint at the mouth of the test tube. So unlike oxygen gas, we won't out it. The hydrogen gas is what should out it. So I know you heard that popping sound, right? And as I place the lighted splint further down, because the gas is coming up, it out it, right? So this metals and acids, that's also a redox reaction. The metal is oxidized and the hydrogen is reduced. So the metal being oxidized, it is the reducing agent, and the hydrogen ions, right, it was moved from plus one to zero, therefore it was reduced. So metals was oxidized, it is the reducing agent. The hydrogen ions were reduced, making it the oxidizing agent, right? So that's it for this video on redox reactions. All right, so metals are reducing agents. All right, remember, hydrogen, even though it's a positive ion, it's a non-metal. All right, so that's it for this video. All right, so before I close, this is the final look at the reactions. So these three test tubes were chromium, right, the dead potassium dichromate, these three potassium permanganate, hydrogen peroxide, alcohol, iron, sulfate, this is copper metal, zinc in copper sulfate, this was magnesium with hydrochloric acid, and this is copper in zinc sulfate. So these were the redox reactions that we looked at. All right, so that's it now.